Hi guys, I'm Irene. You're watching Perpetually Paperback, and today I'm going to be talking about Julie Garwood's Ransom. So truly, let me tell you, this book was fantastic. It was a joy. It is part of the Highland Laird series. It's the second book. The first one was The Secret, and I cannot thank my friend Connie enough for showing me this series. Wow. So very recently, I would say. So just in this past year, I've really been exploring a lot more historical romance. And there's obviously like staples of the genre, so to speak. So this was one where it was like, it was the Highland series, right? So it deals with Highland stereotypes, we're gonna go with. I don't wanna say Highland things because I don't know that. But anyway. So basically the story follows, and the reason that it's fantastic is because it actually has everything. The romance is literally the least interesting part of this whole book, and even that's still good. So basically it opens with Lady Jillian, who at this point in the prologue is a very, very little child, along with her sister Kristen. And they live with their loving father. Well, very early, like as this is pretty much happening, they are being sieged. And so the king, in order to protect them, basically is like, you and your sister need to go escape, take this box. And he gives the box to his older daughter, Kristen. And this box is very special to King John. It belonged to his great love, Arianne, I think is the name. And basically he will do anything to get it back. As this castle is being sieged, we don't really fully understand why this is happening. We just know that the girls are little and they need to escape. Things happen as they try and escape and it doesn't go well. They get separated. Jillian is captured. So this is kind of where the story sort of breaks off. She's captured by the person that sieged the castle, who I want to say was named Baron Alford, but really we can just call him like a piece of shit because he was, and I don't remember his name. So this person basically takes Jillian and is like, I'm going to exile you. You need to live with your uncle, but you're sort of my captive. So she goes, lives her life with her uncle. At this point, she's in her, I think, early 20s again when we see her. At this point of marrying age. So she ends up being called again to Baron Alford's, where she ends up, like I said, as a captive. During this time, she ends up rescuing this little boy who was taken from one of the Highland clans. So it was the wrong boy, ultimately. And as they're there, she basically resolves to say, I am going to take you home. Like, it's going to be my job. I'm going to take care of you. I will take you home. She then basically, she carries this child with her. So he sort of, or they help each other pretty much. And he tells her that he needs to go to his uncle's house, which is the closest to where they are. His uncle happens to be Brodick. So if you read The Secret, this is one of Ian Maitland's men. One of the ones that goes to England to find an English wife. So this is far after that, but they end up going to Brodick's, and Brodick is like, what is this? What is happening? So he basically resolves to help them get to Ian's. He takes them all the way there. And during the trip, he and Jillian sort of start to get a little bit closer. And like, you can tell there's an obvious connection because the book is about them for starters. And also, duh. So they end up making it all the way to Ian's, which is wonderful because once they get there, like as if it wasn't good already, no, it gets amazing. Ian Ramsey, who ends up showing up, and the reason that Ramsey needs to be there is because Jillian knows that Kristen is in Ramsey's territory. She doesn't know where, she doesn't know what name she's going by now, she just knows that she's part of that clan. So that's where her goal is to go and find her. That's what she needs. So she basically recruits Brodick to help her. And you can tell that he's sort of like being very like possessive and jealous. I don't know, I thought it was adorable because he's like very quiet about it and very like, you're mine. And she's like, yeah, but like, no. So as they're there, Ramsey gets there. And then there's this whole aspect of like, all the girls love Ramsey. Like he is the hottest shit, right? She just like can't see anyone but Brodick. It's awesome. And then on top of that, there's like a very obvious, like everyone else knows they're into each other. And it's like beyond obvious. But once the three of them get together, Ian and Ramsey are just negging Brodick so hard, but right in front of him. And it's like, it's just absolutely gorgeous. And he's just there like, I'm sorry, you guys literally know I'm like standing right here. It's hilarious. The banter is top notch. The banter is truly what made me love it. The story's just well written. Everything that's happened, super plot driven. They're like, it's a traveling story. I don't know if that's, I think some people just don't like those, but they're traveling the whole time. There's a point to it, obviously. But anyway, so once they're there, they end up deciding they're going to go to Ramsay's. She asks Braddock if he'll come with her, and obviously he does. Then there's this whole other thing that happens at Ramsay's, that when they get there, he then has to take care of this girl named Bridget, who becomes friends with Jillian, and her parents sort of like kicked her out in this real bad situation. So they're all there, and she and Bridget sort of are like, well, we don't really need them to like get this done. So they just sort of like decide that they won't be left behind, but they sort of like just get into shit. Also, Jillian is beat up more than any heroine I've seen in any book so far. She's just like getting beat up left and right. It makes sense for the story, but like, girl, you would think you'd learn some self-defense at this point. Anyway, so her and Bridget get up to some stuff. They end up being like caught in this coup that really was meant not for them, but they got caught in it anyway. And like, Jillian is shot because, you know, shit like that just happens to her. So during this whole process, obviously the men are like off doing something. They're like surveying the land or something. She's trying to find her sister. The whole sister aspect, that part was a little bit hard in the chest part. It didn't make me cry, actually, which is surprising because everything makes me cry. But no. So they end up like, as this all happens, they end up being like, no, we're going to get revenge. And Jillian's whole thing is, she's like, do not go to Baron Alford's without me. He's going to kill my uncle, and I love my uncle, and if that happens, I'm going to be upset. They leave without her. So she's like, no, not that. I'm going to take the little dude that saved us from the coup and Bridget, and we're going to go figure it out. So while she does that, she ends up playing this whole scheme, which is, by the way, brilliant. And as she's there at Baron Alford's, I don't know, should I tell you the ending? If you don't want to know the ending, skip away now. But there's been spoilers from the get-go. So at this point, she basically calls, before she ends up getting there, she basically tells Prince John, like, hey, I know where your box is. And she really didn't at this point. She was just kind of like, I hope this is right. But King John, I think I keep calling him Prince John. No, King John shows up, saves the day, and then another whole thing happens there. Like, literally every place they go, there is action on action on action. I have always said that I really like character-driven stories, and I 100% do. But damn, these plot ones are getting good. Yeah, this was, honestly, I loved this way more than the first one. Not that the first one, I liked the first one, but this one was fantastic. I enjoyed myself so much. And at the end, Uncle Morgan rips Braddock a new one in this most awesome way. Everything about it was just like so cute. And also very much like, as many times as Jillian gets herself beat up, she is not gonna let that stop her. She makes it at the end. I loved it. I thought it was fantastic. I thought it was wonderful. I would love to talk to anyone about this one, like big time. So if you've read this, please tell me what you think, especially if you didn't like it, because oh my goodness, I'd be so interested to know why. Like, I couldn't even see it. Like, I don't get it. Why would you not like this? It was wonderful. I mean, if that's not the kind of dude, I don't even know if that's the kind of dude I like. I don't know. I just loved it. It was great. 5 stars. Tell me if you liked it. If not, you should definitely read it. I hope you like it. Okay. See you guys next time. Bye.